In this tutorial, I'm going to show you the most powerful way to change the depth of field, blur the background in Photoshop. All right, let's get started with this train. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to choose filter, and under filter, we're going to go into neural filters. And we're going to go and we're going to turn on depth blur. So maybe you've seen this filter before, but I'm going to show you how to manually override things and get a much better result than just using the neural filter on its own. If you wanted to change the area that's in focus, you could simply just click on different parts of the photo and notice how this will recompose it. But one of the things you may have noticed, look here. See how there's areas that get missed? Let's look at how to fix all of that and actually use a better way of applying it than depth blur. So we're going to go all the way to the bottom and choose output depth map only. Now this depth map, where things are lighter means they're further away, where they're darker means they're closer to the camera. Let's click OK. Let's start with the first trick that you might not have seen before. Let's increase the effect of this. Hit Control L for levels. And then what we're going to do is take the shadow area and let's pull that up a little bit. And it's also going to the midtone. So what we're doing is, and we're intensifying those grays to give us more of an effect. The next thing we need to do is, if you look at this area here, we want to make sure that that is the same as the background. So it's on the same depth plane. So the different shades of gray will put it on a different plane. So let's make a selection around these areas. So why don't we try the object selection tool and just drag in that little area there. All right, let's grab another lasso. Let's use the polygon lasso and we're going to add to this selection. So the way to do that is to hold down the shift key and we're just going to click. Turn back on the top layer. Notice these are the shades that we want to be painting with. So grab a brush, hold down the alt or the option key. And that will make a sample, make the brush a little larger, and let's paint those out. Same thing here, just pick up the same kind of tones. All right, let's go to the channels. And what we want to do now is duplicate one of those channels. So let's just grab any of them, red, green, or blue, they're all the same. Just drag it into there, and then this gives us a map. We'll just call it map. Doesn't really matter what you name it. Make sure you select RGB again. Let's just duplicate the background so we can show a before and after. Right, let's use a really powerful tool to apply the blur. We're going to choose filter, blur, and we're going to be using the lens blur. This actually simulates the lens on a camera. So as you can see here, you can choose different types of apertures. Now, the important thing is we want to make sure under source, we're choosing our map. Let's increase the blur so we can see the radius. Now, watch what happens. If we click the set focal point, if we click on the front, notice how now it comes in nice and sharp. Or we could click back here. We could click on different parts of the photo to bring these areas into focus. And notice we get the proper background blur in these areas there because of the way we selected them. Click OK. We look at it before and after. So as you can see, these automatically generated depth maps are incredibly powerful. Let me know your thoughts underneath if you learned anything new in this video. And if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Hit subscribe, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. And do me a favor, if you got any value out of this, smash that like button into dust. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.